let's get into the film, Ryan, and look at what this kid brings to the table. And the first thing you're going to see is this is a guy that plays the boundary. Let's get this. Y'all don't need to see us on this one. This is a kid that plays into the boundary, and you guys can see right away the incredible, incredible length that he brings to the table.
It's this insane, is Ryan,
man. Just really long kid. Really long kid. And he's very smooth, right? I think that's something. It's funny. This wasn't a great first clip. Here's the thing I'll say about Leonard Moore. The first thing that I notice when I watch him play, very inefficient footwork. He has a lot going on, and you don't want a corner to have a lot going on. And so sometimes that can mask a little bit his just how smooth and flexible he is. But then you see plays like this one coming up right here, right? And you're like, okay, look at this suddenness. Is this the one? No, this isn't the one. It's the other punt return. But this is the one where you see the speed. You see how loose he is. He's such a long strider, right? This is where you can see him moving.
Did you see him reach out to pick up the football too? Yeah. You want to talk about that arm length again, man? Like, it's wild. It's wild to watch.
Yeah. So one of the things is this is a good tackle. This is what we talk about. He's a more than willing tackler. Look how hard that receiver has no chance of getting into Leonard Moore's body. Watch this. That kid cannot get into his chest. He just dismisses it. This is a 175-pound kid right here. Just quickly dispatching that guy. Going low, that's the other thing. Cam Hart's really developed into a really good tackler because he's learned from some past mistakes, and he's learned to go low and really go through the thighs and knees of a guy. And you see this right here from Leonard Moore, which can be hard for a 6'2" guy. And of course, he knocks the ball out. But it's the block destruction that happens first. And I talk about this in the class impact that I just put out. His potential for block destruction. It's like, yeah, you may like him in the boundary, but good Lord, he may be impossible not to play to the field when you talk about just how good he is at covering ground and coming out and blocking, the block destruction, making tackles. You see the stick there. I mean, this is a kid who's 175 pounds, and he is a more than willing tackler and arrives with some force, Ryan. So you start saying, well, once this kid gets into the weight room, goodness gracious, he's just toying with this guy right here, Ryan. Right. But here's the thing. There's a lot going on with the feet there. A lot going on in the feet there.
Yeah. But it's to be expected, some of the wasted movement with the lower half. Because again, he is a taller kid, right? He is a guy and he's young. Yeah. And those are things that you need to work out and you need to continue to improve upon. But there are a lot of reps on here where you just like that change of direction right there. That's not ordinary, right? Like that's a different type of athlete. At 6'2", you don't see guys that are able to change direction like this. And then here's your play, man, where you see a little bit of that elusiveness. You see that speed hitting the corner here as a punt returner. I mean,
yeah, this is a lot of tools. Talking about. Yeah, this is the one that right there, that change of direction that he shows three different times, like this right here, boom. That's really good COD right there, Ryan. Really good change of direction. And just to fit, and look at the confidence in his hands. Right. That's the other thing is you see from a corner. He's got very confident hands. And then the ability to bounce that thing outside. You see, he stumbles a little bit and then still is able to regain his speed. So you see the quickness. And yes, you're right. A long guy is going to take more time to get his footwork right. And that's going to come. But the tools are there. Look how
quickly did you see that
he drives in this ball.
I was going to say the change of direction on this is incredible because you think that because he's playing a lot of zone early on in this film, right? And usually if I see a tall corner that's playing a ton of zone, I assume he hasn't changed direction very well. But then you see those types of reps where he's able to stick his foot in the ground and come downhill. And I think it's a little rare of a skill set that he has, right?
I want to move on to this play here real quick, Ryan, just because we'll have more chance to talk about that rareness because you're absolutely right. But I think this is the thing too, is I love the feel he shows right here. So this is basically, he's playing quarters coverage and I think it's quarters coverage, but I don't know because I think it might be some weird cover three because there's actually a deep safety back there. So I'm wondering if this is like an end of half play, right? The way that they're playing this. But watch how he reads the quarterback's eyes. Why does he leave his outside man? Because as soon as the quarterback, watch this. I want y'all to watch when the quarterback is throwing. And as soon as the quarterback cocks back, he starts closing inside. The ball hasn't left the quarterback's hand yet. But why is he doing that? Because he read the quarterback's eyes from that kind of distance, closes on the seam route, and then I don't know, did he pick it off or just break it up? Let's see here. Hey, picked it off, even though his own guy drilled him.
It's so impressive, man.
It's that impressive too. It's that feel for the game that he shows, the route recognition that he shows. Look how quickly he closes downhill on the swing route. That plant does, and redirect.
It might be the number five in the fact that he's long, but he does look like Cam Hart on that type of rep because Cam gets downhill real fast against short routes.
Yeah. Yes. Out. Yes. No question. And again, his stance is just all over the place. The technique when it comes to coverage is just not there yet. But his, you do see it here. What I love about this rep, Ryan, why does he attack? Look how he attacks his corner. He goes outside because his primary responsibility is you are the force player, or you're the force player. You cannot let them out leverage you. Is the outside corner in this defense? If you get out leveraged, it might be a touchdown. But he goes outside. Right, so execution of his assignment, boom. And then he just blows this corner up or this receiver up and then comes off to make the tackle. But he does it after dismissing the corner and forcing the ball carry back inside. And then he comes off to it. That's a very sound, fundamental play that also shows some physicality, Ryan. And those are the things you say. This kid's just not talented. This kid knows how to play football. This kid's a disciplined player from an assignment standpoint. He's got to clean up his technique a lot. But he understands it. Look how he maneuvers here on this concept. So you've got an outside receiver that's basically faking a crack and then goes vertical. So initially he's closing on the outside receiver, but he's got his eyes on that receiver to the backfield. He sees the wheel route, and so he gets depth because he's playing a deep third. He gets depth and just says, "Hey, look, I see it. I'm quick route recognition." Gets depth. As soon as he sees that guy hitch up, he plants a little too much footwork there. But again, that's something that that can be corrected. But once he plants, he explodes downhill and breaks that up. That's a combination of great skill and great understanding of how to play the football, how to play the game of football. And that's what I'm talking. That's what I really like, Ryan. This kid is not just an athlete. He's a smart football player as well.
Well, and you make a great point about the inefficient footwork, because even on that one, Brian, like he's high in his pedal, you know, like it's not an easy thing for him to change direction. But I think that, again, that's why you see this kid's a really good athlete. And once the technique catches up to the athleticism he has, sky is the limit. And you know, here he is coming off the edge. Obviously, he has no problem with playing with a level of physicality. Right. And you see that in his ability to reroute players. In the pass game, you see that with the ability to get off a block. You see him coming here on a cornerback fire and finishing the play.
Well, what I like about this too, Ryan, is the cornerback fire takes him on a high angle. So he's playing high on the nature of it because he's heading towards the mesh, right? And the running back is going inside. His ability to recover and still get hands on and drag this guy down is actually an underrated play there because he isn't taking an angle to square up the running back, but he's still able to get off and go make that play. On, you know, it's a good football play, man. It's a good football play.
Here he is, obviously in the bottom of the screen, playing a little press. Oh, here comes another cornerback fire.
Look at the length, though. It's like he could almost touch the ground once he gets in his stance.
Yeah,
you know, this kid's really long, really long. You got to love the length of this kid, man. And you see pictures of him, Ryan. He's got some body to fill out too, right? Look how smooth he closes on this post route. Well, it's more of a slant route. I don't love the angle that he takes. You know, he's actually a little bit of a trail position if this ball is a little bit better thrown. Maybe the guy completes it, but he undercuts that thing quickly and gets his hands on the ball. That's the other thing too, Ryan. He in this film, he gets his hands on a lot of passes.
Yes.
And you want to see that. He gets his hands on a lot of throws.
And why does length matter? It's that last play, right, where he's in trail and he's able to still get his hand in there for the pass breakup. Those things matter so much, and this is one of those – people will call him pesky, right? Pesky at the line of scrimmage, pesky at the catch point, but he's going to break up a lot of passes just for the reach that he has.
Mm-hmm. Misses a little bit there on the tackle, but you see the effort. You know, it's not, to me, really a highlight, but I kind of like it when kids put non-highlights on their highlight film, you know.
Yep.
You get to see some of this. Again, look at the patience, letting the post-snap switch develop, staying in your zone, being disciplined, then get your depth. He's undercutting on this particular play. This looks like cover two, Ryan. So he's undercutting You're going to run vertical until the guy in your zone stops. He's run vertical. He stops at the moment. Watch this. So watch the slot receiver. So what they're doing here is basically they're running smash from an inverted standpoint. So usually in smash, this slot guy is going to run the corner, and they call it a smash route. The inside guy will run like a hitch, you know, conversion route. In this one, they're running smash from an invert. So the outside guy is going to actually run the hitch. The inside guy is going to run basically a sort of a square corner on that one. And so he is getting depth until someone attacks his zone. You can see it. So as soon as he sees the outside guy kind of go vertical, okay, so he comes inside. So here's what's going through his head. When that guy's going inside like it's a crack, he's like, okay, he's going into the inside linebacker's zone. But as soon as he squares up and gets vertical, then you see Leonard Moore get vertical, right? Because he's got to carry that until someone attacks his zone. Once that guy hitches up, you're going to see he stops at almost the same time that the receiver does, and then just quickly drives on the football and makes that play. That's just a really instinctive, fundamentally sound football play, right?
And I'll say this too, we're going to get super excited about all the talent that he has from a physical perspective, right? But I feel like things that we keep talking about are also the intelligence that he has, right? The mental awareness. I mean, he plays a lot of zone at his level. And if you've ever coached high school football or just played high school football, you know how frustrating it can be to watch a corner play zone because they don't have a great instinct to when to let guys go and to pass off and do all those types of things. And you see Leonard Moore, he's a very intelligent football player because he just understands zone awareness. And it sounds like a small thing, but a lot of cornerbacks his age struggle with that. They really do. And I think that this is not only a physically impressive football player, I think that there's a really nice mental side of the game to how he plays as well.
When he's a tremendous student, you know, his dad, I think, works at the University of Texas, you know, very academically oriented. I mean, reminds me a lot of the James family, to be honest with you, Ryan. Braylon James, very Which similar family backgrounds. You know what I mean? Like, now their parents do different things, but just the focus on, you know, getting a great education, the importance of academics, there's a lot of similarities. And of course, Braylon's from the Round Rock area too, but you're getting a kid that comes to Notre Dame knowing that I'm not just coming here to play football. I'm coming here to get a great education. And you heard him say it. I mean, it's the first thing he said. I wanted to go somewhere with great academics. You know, there's a lot more kids out there like that than people think. And you just got to get them. That's the big key. You just got to get them.
And I love that. I love that he returns punts. I really do, because he plays obviously in a big area against a lot of great competition. The fact that he is the chosen person to be the punt returner, I think does say a lot to the all around athletic profile that he has. I really think it does. Cause I mean, he's playing with some other good players, obviously, right? Like, he's not playing with a bunch of scrubs. So, which is always a good sign.
Right here, Ryan, is one of his better reps. This is one of his best reps. You know, you see him press, right? The transition is very – look how smooth the hips are. His footwork is not great, but you see how smooth the hips are. He mirrors this guy on this route. You know, stays high on him, right? Stays on that upfield shoulder. He's got his eyes on him, gets his hands on him, but not grabby. As soon as the guy stops, he stays right in front of him and closes on him, right? The ball doesn't come his way, so it doesn't look like a great highlight, but this is one of the better reps right here where you just see all the skills. Once his footwork improves, this is going to be just those reps right there are going to be even more impressive.
And I think that that's the reason that some people struggle with cornerback evaluations at times is that a lot of the best reps are – involving the ball not being thrown that way, right? The fact that he did not have that ball even slightly looking his way tells me that they understand that, like, that he's locking them down, right? I mean, you can't just watch the targets, the pass breakups, like, all those things matter, obviously. But the fact that the ball was only thrown at him, I think he said a total of like 18 times all year, right? Says a lot that you need to know about how much teams respect him.
Yeah, Ryan, right here is another good rep. You the other day we were talking about what makes a good man cornerback, and you said patience. Look at this. This is patience right here. Now, this play gets blown dead, but he shoots his hips. What patience to me is, when a guy shoots his hands, he doesn't shoot his upper body.
Yes.
Right? So what you'll see is guys will kind of lunge. He doesn't lunge here, right? You just see him shoot his hands, but he sits on his butt. He's still on the balls of his feet. He's ready for this guy to make a move. And then when the guy declares, he doesn't start moving downfield till the guy declares. Yep. That's a really, really good rep. you really see that. Because there's not a ton of man of him playing man, but in the snaps where he is playing press man, it's really impressive.
Yeah, and press is so – again, people I think have a misunderstanding of it because they just think about the upper body and the punch and all that great stuff. Press corners, the feet matter just as much as the punch. It really does. You have to get everything aligned and keep in proper position and be able to have independent hands while you're working through your press and being able to move your feet. And I think you see that. There's a level of patience and a level of confidence that this kid has that all corners need. Like, they need that type of stuff. And again, man, I mean, I can't speak more highly of this young man because I think that he has just the tools to be an excellent football player at the next level.